وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد وإن شرح في كتاب أخلاق حملة القرآن written by الإمام الأجري رحمه الله We stopped at where the author رحمه الله said حدثنا أبو بكر عبد الله بن محمد بن عبد الحميد الواسطي قال حدثنا زيد بن أخزم قال حدثنا محمد بن الفضل قال حدثنا سعيد بن زيد عن أبي حمزة عن إبراهيم عن علقمة بن قيس عن عبد الله يعني بن مسعود قال لا تنثروا نثر الدقل ولا تهذوه هذ الشعر قفوا عند عجائبه وحركوا به القلوب ولا يكن هم أحدكم آخر الصورة The author, rahimahullah, as you can see, he now goes into quotes from the Sahabas. And the author, rahimahullah, brings ayat, he brings ahadiths, and he also brings quotes from the early generation, the Sahabas and the Tabi'in and the Tabi'u Tabi'in and the Ulama. Here, he brings a statement of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. So the Alqama here is Alqama ibn Qaysin, narrated from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. Abdullah, whenever you hear in the hadith books, if they ever say an Abdullah like that, they are referring to Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. Like, remember that. Abdullah unrestrictedly is referring to Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he said, لا تنثروه نثر الدقل. Do not scatter the Qur'an as if it were dates falling from a tree. And he don't recite the Qur'an and read the Qur'an as though or like dates falling from a tree. The dates here is referred to tamr, which is yabis. Dates which are not good. Don't recite the Qur'an like that. وَلَا تَهُذُّوهُ هَذَّ الشِّعْرِ And do not recite the Qur'an fast and quick the way you recite poetry. قِفُ عِنْدَ عَجَائِبِهِ Stand and ponder over the fascination that are in the Qur'an. يعني fill your hearts with the fascination of the Qur'an and the powerful meanings that are in the Qur'an. قِفُ عِنْدَ عَجَائِبِهِ وَحَرِّكُوا بِهِ الْقُلُوبَ And also move your hearts when you're reading the Qur'an. يعني use your hearts. Don't just read it from your tongue. Don't just make your tongue the only thing that moves, but also do your heart. Make it move. Make your heart keep up with what your mouth is reciting. In other words, he means ponder over the Qur'an. وَلَا يَكُنْ هَمُّ أَحَدِكُمْ آخِرَ السُّورَةِ And do not make your aspiration to just finish the Qur'an. Oh, alhamdulillah, I finished today 100 lines or 100 verses. Alhamdulillah. Don't make that your goal. Make your goal to ponder over the Qur'an. It has been transmitted from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu that a man said to him, إِنِّي لَأَقْرَأُ الْمُفَصَّلَ فِي رَكْعَةٍ I read the mufassal of the Qur'an in one rak'ah. Abdullah ibn Abbas, he said, you read a whole entire mufassal in one rak'ah? He said, هَذَّا كَهَذِّ الشِّعْرِ Then that means you read it very fast. إِنَّ أَقْوَامًا يَقْرَأُونَ الْقُرْآنَ لَا يُجَاوِزُ تَرَاقِيَهُمْ There are a people who are going to recite the Qur'an and it will not pass their collarbone. ولكن إذا وقع في القلب فرسخ فيه نفع. But if the Quran goes to the heart and it settles in the heart, it benefits. Now, there's going to be a people who are going to read the Quran a lot. And the Khawarij, they read the Quran a lot, but it doesn't go to the heart. And they don't ponder over the Quran. They don't contemplate. This is the problem the Khawarij have. The Quran is just on the tongue. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, and he said, "Hadhan ka hadhi al-shi'ri." Then you're reading it the way the poetry is recited. You see, he condemned it. What is that? When we read the Quran, what is it that we should try to attain from the recitation of the Quran? The Sahabas, they used to recite the Quran tadabburan wa amalan. They used to read the Quran so they can contemplate and they can implement it. We lack that today. Those are the two objectives of the companions when it came to reading the Quran. The author, rahimahullah, he says, وَحَدَّثَنَا أَبُو بَكْرٍ أَيْضًا قال حدثنا الحسن بن محمد بن الصباح الزعفراني قال حدثنا عبد الوهاب بن عطاء قال سمعت أبا عبيدة الناجي يقول إنه سمع الحسن يقول أبا عبيدة الناجي هاد حسن البصري رحمه الله say إلزموا كتاب الله. What does it mean, إِلْزَمُوا كِتَابَ اللَّهِ? It means hold on to the Qur'an تَدَبُّرًا وَتَأَمُّلًا وَمُجَاهَدَةً لِلنَّفْسِ عَلَى فَهْمِ وَالْعَمَلَ بِهِ. Hold on to the Qur'an in pondering over it. Hold on to the Qur'an by observing it and looking at it and analyzing it. Hold on to the Qur'an by implementing it. وَتَتَبَّعُوا مَا فِيهِ مِنَ الْأَمْثَالِ. And follow the parables that the Qur'an gives. The Qur'an gives us a lot of parables. What do we do? We follow those parables that the Qur'an gives. Allah Ta'ala gives many of them. Allah says, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ ضُرِبَ مَثَلٌ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ تَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ لَنْ يَخْلُقُوا ذُبَابًا وَلَوِ اجْتَمَعُوا لَهُ وَإِنْ يَسْلُبْهُمُ الذُّبَابُ شَيْئًا لَا يَسْتَنْقِضُوهُ مِنْهُ ضَعُفَ الطَّالِبُ وَالْمَطْلُوبُ. And Allah has given us a parable here. That the people, they're worshipping things that are weak and pathetic. The things that they're worshipping. Also Allah Tabaraka wa ta'ala gives us a parable of the iman. Alam tara kayfa daraba Allahu mathalan kalimatan tayyibatan ka shajaratin tayyibatin asluha thabit wa far'uha fi as-sama' tu'ti ukulaha kulla hinin bi idni rabbiha wa yadhribu Allahu al-amthala lin-nasi la'allahum yatadhakkarun. Also Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another ayah, wa tilka al-amthalu nadribuha lin-nasi wa ma ya'qiluha illa al-'alimun. Allah Tabaraka wa ta'ala gives many parables in the Quran. The believer is compared to the palm tree. Al-Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim both narrated, وَاللَّفْضُ لِلْبُخَارِي, and the wording is the wording of Al-Imam al-Bukhari, that Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, he said, بَيْنَا نَحْنُ عِنْدَ النَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم. One day we were with the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم at Julus, and we were sitting. إِذْ أُوتِيَا بِجُمَّازِ نَخْلَةٍ. When the Prophet ﷺ was brought, جُمَّازِ نَخْلَةٍ was brought to him عليه الصلاة والسلام. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet said, إِنَّ مِنَ الشَّجَرَةِ لِمَا بَرَكَتُهُ كَبَرَكَةِ الْمُسْلِمِ فَظَنَنْتُ أَنُّ يَعْنِي نَخْلَةً. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said that there is a tree in terms of its barakah is like the barakah of the believer. يعني it's like the same as the believer. فظننت, I thought to myself, أنه يعني النخلة, that he meant the نخلة, the palm tree. فردت أن أقول, Abdullah ibn Umar, he said, I wanted to say, oh Messenger of Allah, I know what tree you're referring to, is the palm tree, the date tree. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم then responded. Abdullah ibn Umar didn't respond. The reason why he didn't respond, because he said, I looked around and I realized I was the youngest. So I never said nothing. So the Prophet answered, he said, هي النخلة. It's a palm tree. So this tree is what the believers compared to. And you can see Allah gives parables. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم gives parables. ولذلك العلامة ابن القيم رحمه الله, he has gathered all of the parables in the Quran in his great book إعلام الموقعين. If you go to the إعلام الموقعين, ابن القيم has a nice chapter where he talks about the parables. And alhamdulillah, it's translated even in English. And some scholars, what they did is that they extracted it from the I'lam al-Waqi'in and they put it separate. And they made it a separate book. But it's originally taken from the I'lam al-Waqi'in by Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullahu ta'ala. وَتَتَبَّعُوا مَا فِيهِ مِنَ الْأَمْثَالِ وَكُونُوا فِيهِ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْبَصَرِ. And be from the people of insight when it comes to the Qur'an. Hassan al-Basri said, وَكُونُوا and be فِيهِ when it comes to the Qur'an مِنْ أَهْلِ الْبَصَرِ. Be from the people of insight. What does he mean by be from the people of insight? يعني be from those people who contemplate and understand the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The author then says, ثم قال رحم الله عبدا عرض نفسه. Hassan al-Basri made dua. After he said that, Hassan al-Basri made a supplication, a dua. He said, رحم الله, may Allah have mercy upon عبدا, a slave. عرض نفسه, presents himself. وعمله, and his actions على كتاب الله تعالى. He presents it to the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he presents his actions to the Qur'an. And looks where his actions are in comparison to the Qur'an. فَإِنْ وَافَقَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ حَمِدَ اللَّهَ وَسَأَلَهُ الزِّيَادَةَ. And if his speech and his actions are in line with the book of Allah, he praises Allah and he asks Allah for more. And for more virtue. وَإِنْ خَالَفَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ. But if he sees that his speech and actions are in opposition to the Qur'an, جَلَّتْ عَظَمَتُهُ عَتَبَ نَفْسَهُ. The person rebukes himself. وَرَجَعَ مِنْ قَرِيبٍ. And he repents quickly. He turns back quickly. And Imam al-Ajurri then said, حَدَّثَنَا أَبُو عَبْدِ اللَّهِ أَحْمَدُ بْنُ الْحَسَنِ بْنِ عَبْدِ الْجَبَّارِ الصُّوفِيُّ قَالَ حَدَّثَنَا شُجَاعِ بْنُ مَخْلَدٍ قَالَ حَدَّثَنَا بْنُ عُلَيَّةَ قَالَ حَدَّثَنَا زِيَادِ بْنُ مَخْرَاقٍ عَنْ مُعَاوِيَةَ بْنِ قُرَّةَ عَنْ أَبِي كِنَانَةَ أَنَّ أَبَا مُوسَى الْأَشْعَرِي رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهُ جمع الذين قرأوا القرآن وهم قريب من 300 فعظم القرآن وقال إن هذا القرآن كائن لكم ذخرا وكائن عليكم وزرا فاتبعوا القرآن ولا يتبعكم فإنه من اتبع القرآن هبط به إلى رياض الجنة ومن اتبعه القرآن زج في قفاه فقذفه في النار. الإمام Muhammad ibn al-Husayn al-Ajurri rahimahullah, he brings a statement of the noble companion Aba Musa al-Ash'ari. Aba Musa al-Ash'ari, he gathered the Qurra, the people of the Quran, 300 of them nearly. And Hassan Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, when he brought all of the 300 Qurra, the people of the Qur'an, he venerated and glorified the Qur'an. And Abu Musa al-Ash'ari spoke high of the Qur'an, venerated the Qur'an, glorified the Qur'an. And he said to them after that, إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ كَائِنٌ لَكُمْ ذُخْرًا. This Qur'an for you is a dhukhr. Dhukhr means a storage. يعني something you've stored for yourself for the day of judgment to save you. وَكَائِنُ عَلَيْكُمْ وِزَرًا. And this Qur'an is also a punishment for you. And it's a reward that you have stacked for the day of judgment, and it can also be a punishment that you have stacked for the day of judgment. And he tells them how. He said, فَاتَّبِعُوا الْقُرْآنَ. Follow the Qur'an. وَلَا يَتَّبِعُكُمْ. Do not let the Qur'an follow you. So if you follow the Qur'an will be a dhukhr for you, a good storage for you. It will benefit you the day of judgment. And if the Qur'an follows you, then it will become a punishment and a sin against you. فَإِنَّهُ مَنِ اتَّبَعَ الْقُرْآنَ هَبَطَ بِهِ إِلَى رِيَاضِ الْجَنَّةِ. Because the person who follows the Qur'an will take you to Jannah. وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَهُ الْقُرْآنُ. And anyone the Qur'an follows him, زج في قفاه, it will throw you into the hellfire. فقذفه في النار. This will lead you to the hellfire. You will be from the dwellers of the hellfire. So what does the Quran have to do in our life? It has to change our life. It has to perfect our life. The Quran must be the thing that we follow. The awamir, the commandments, the prohibitions, the Quran has to be that for us. It can't just be something that we put on top of a shelf and it gathers the dust. Al-Imam Al-Ajurri then said, Akhbarana Abu Muhammad, Akhbarana Abu Muhammadin Yahya ibn Muhammad ibn Sa'idin. Qala, Akhbarana Al-Husayn ibn Al-Hasan Al-Maruziyu, Akhbarana ibn Mubarak, Anna Salimun Al-Makiyu an Al-Hasani Qala. Hasan Al-Basriyu said the following, Man ahabba an ya'lama ma huwa. Anyone who wants to know what he or she is. Do you really know? Do you really want to know who you are? Do you want to know who you really are? فَلْيَعْرِضْ نَفْسَهُ عَلَى الْقُرْآنِ Then present yourself to the Qur'an. Present yourself to the Qur'an. That's going to be the way for you to find out who you really are. وَحَدَّثَنَا أَبُو مُحَمَّدٍ أَيْضًا قَالَ حَدَّثَنَا الْحُسَيْنِ قَالَ حَدَّثَنَا عَبْدِ اللَّهِ قال حدثنا عبد الملك بن أبي سليمان عن عطاء وقيس بن سعد عن مجاهد يعني مجاهد بن جبر التابعي He recited the ayah يتلونه حق تلاوته They recite the verse of Allah the way it deserves to be recited مجاهد said it means they recite the Quran the way it deserves to be recited means يعملون بحق عمله They implement the Qur'an the way it deserves to be implemented. Al-Imam Al-Ajurri then said, قَالَ أَخْبَرَنَا أَبُو عَبْدِ اللَّهِ أَحْمَدَ بْنُ الْحَسَنِ بْنِ عَبْدِ الْجَبَّارِنِ الصُّوفِي قَالَ حَدَّثَنَا شُجَاعِ بْنُ مَخْلَدٍ قَالَ حَدَّثَنَا أَبُو مُعَاوِيَةَ الضَّرِيرُ قَالَ حَدَّثَنَا عَبْدُ رَبِّهِ بْنُ أَيْمَنَ عَنْ عَطَاءٍ قَالَ إِنَّمَا الْقُرْآنُ إنما القرآن عبر The Quran is عبر lessons The Quran is عبر يعني مواعظ وعبر The Quran is reminders and it is also it is fascination That's what Allah said in the ayah لقد كان في قصصهم عبرة لأولي الألباب That's what Allah said that in the stories there is what عبرة Ibra is a lesson. The Quran has those ibar and those mawa'id.
وَقَبْلَ أَنْ أَذْكُرَ أَخْلَاقَ أَهْلِ الْقُرْآنِ وَمَا يَنْبَغِي لَهُمْ أَنْ يَتَأَدَّبُوا بِهِ أَذْكُرُ فَضْلَ حَمَلَةِ الْقُرْآنِ لِيَرْغَبُوا فِي تِلَاوَتِهِ وَالْعَمَلِ بِهِ وَالتَّوَاضُعِ لِمَنْ تَعَلَّمُوا مِنْهُ أَوْ عَلَّمُوهُ الْإِمَامُ الْآجُرِّيُّ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ says Before I go into speaking about the etiquettes of the carriers of the Qur'an وَمَا يَنْبَغِي لَهُمْ أَنْ يَتَأَدَّبُوا بِهِ And before I speak about the manners that the people of the Qur'an must adorn themselves with أَذْكُرُ فَضْلَ حَمَلَةِ الْقُرْآنِ I'm going to mention the virtue of the ones who are carrying the Qur'an. I'm going to mention the virtue of the ones that are carrying the Qur'an. So before I go into the etiquettes, I'm going to speak about the virtue of the carriers of the Qur'an. Why? لِيَرْغَبُوا فِي تِلَاوَتِي So the people have this desire and this drive to want to recite the Qur'an. وَالْعَمَلِ بِهِ And also to implement it. والتواضع لمن تعلم منه and humility to the one they learn from or the one that they teach. So the author rahimahullah is now going to go into النصوص والأدلة evidences, textual evidences that mention the virtue of the one who recites the Quran. And the reason why he's doing this is تخفيزا للهمم to increase the aspiration in our hearts and place in our hearts humility and humbleness in learning and studying the Qur'an. I, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to stop there bi-idhnillah al-kareem for today's class. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. استغفرك واتوب اليك
السلام عليكم If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running make sure you head over to amauathome.com